already about
your baby. Oh, I know, I saw. Was it an owie right here? Pediatric pulmonary hypertension is an elevated blood pressure in the lungs, similar to how people can have a high blood pressure in the blood vessels in their body. You can also have a high blood pressure in the lungs, and it causes different types of complications. The vast majority of our patient panel are premature lung disease and congenital heart disease. So both of those entities have an independent risk factor for this high blood pressure in the lungs. So I'd say about 50% of our patients tend to have this premature lung disease, 50% tend to have congenital heart disease. It sort of depends on what the exact reason for the pulmonary hypertension might be. So for patients that have PH, as we sort of like to abbreviate pulmonary hypertension, PH, if it's coming from lung disease, oftentimes you'll have worsening oxygen saturations. You may need increased respiratory support, so you may need to be have a breathing tube helping you breathe for you. But oftentimes there's really no signs or symptoms. It can be kind of an insidious disease, and we typically will have some sort of, if a patient has a risk factor, we tend to screen those patients and ultimately make the diagnosis based on ultrasound of the heart or echocardiography. For the patients that we know have a risk factor, so the more premature the baby is, the higher the risk they have for having lung disease associated with their prematurity. And the higher the risk, the more severe the lung disease they have, the more severe the pulmonary hypertension they tend to have. And this is very relevant because in those patients, a diagnosis of PH increases the mortality 4 to 5 fold. So it's very important that we make an early diagnosis in these babies and potentially start therapies early on. The patients that have premature lung disease, heart disease, we also take care of patients that have other syndromes such as trisomy 21 or Down syndrome, which is an independent risk factor for having pulmonary hypertension. And that's sort of incompletely understood, but it's partially related to patients with Down syndrome commonly having lung disease, they commonly have heart disease, and they have obstructive sleep breathing patterns, which can put them at higher risk. So Down syndrome, a lot of the patients that we see have Down syndrome. Achondroplasia can also be an independent risk factor, something called DeGeorge syndrome. So there's different types of syndromes. Sickle cell disease is another one that commonly has PH associated with it. So there's sort of independent groups that have a separate disease process which puts them at risk for PH. The most severe type of pulmonary hypertension, which is called idiopathic pulmonary hypertension, as well as heritable pulmonary hypertension or genetic associated pulmonary hypertension, is very rare. So 1 or 2 cases per million births. So in that most severe group, the idiopathic or heritable pulmonary hypertension, they don't tend to outgrow it. It's progressive, and it tends to become increasingly refractory to even the most potent medications that we have. And they may end up needing, again, either a lung transplant or some other surgical procedure to try to stabilize their heart function. Fortunately, for most groups, there are treatment options that will stabilize the disease, and ultimately, those patients are able to come off those medications as they get older. As they have more lung growth, they will be able to grow out of their pulmonary hypertension. When I first came to UC Davis in the Sacramento area, I didn't identify any sort of program that was specializing in taking care of these patients. So I'm really proud to have really the only pediatric PH program in the Sacramento area. This is really a village that takes care of these patients. The gold standard of a good PH program is going to involve many different components, because all of these, whatever the cause of the PH, there are multiple different specialties that are involved in taking care of them. So we've been very fortunate to be able to take care of patients coming from Sutter, coming from Kaiser and other institutions because of our specialty care. And oftentimes we're able to sort of improve their pH and ultimately get them back to their sort of home institution. But it has been a very rewarding experience.